Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Amar Nawaz Khan and I am student of Frontier Medical and Dental College, Ahmedabad. Today I am going to discuss the three main topics of oral cavity or biology. First of all, I have to discuss the contact areas. So, what is contact area? Contact areas are actually the places where the two adjacent teeth touches each other. In a complete arch, in one arch, the two adjacent teeth touches with each other and it goes on from anterior to posterior. But here we have an exception, that the posterior most tooth touches with one side, but at the other side there are no other teeth. So there's an here we have an exception. So when contact area increases in size with age, when the contact area size increases when the age overcomes. After eruption and initial contact with adjacent teeth, they approach a point in size, but with age they broaden and call contact area. It means that after sharp eruption and initial points, at initial contact, the adjacent teeth touches each other at a point which then proceeds and abrupt, and then it's called contact area. This broadness is due to the abruption that occur when the proximal surfaces of the teeth rub against each other. It means that when this broadness occurs when the adjacent teeth touches each other. Here we have a diagram shows the contact area of the two teeth. The proper locations of contact area aid in stabilizing the dental arch. It means that when we have a proper contact areas, it stabilizes our dental arch. Another function which proper contact area serves is that it prevents food material from slipping between the teeth. It means that if we have a proper contact areas, the food do not slip between the tooth. Sometimes chronic packing of food usually result in inflammation, for which replacement of dental restoration is extreme importance. Its proper location is also important in food flow pattern. So here we come to conclusion that the proper contact areas are must for proper functions. So we have now rules of our contact areas. Number one rule is the contact area become more cervically located from anterior to posterior in each quadrant. It means that we move from anterior to posterior, contact areas move cervically. Number two, an individual tooth, distal area is more cervically located. It means that when we have one individual tooth at distal part, the contact area will be cervically located. As we move from anterior to posterior, its size increases. The anterior teeth have contact area centered in basolingual dimension, while in posterior tooth it have in buccal center. Now we have interproximal spaces. So what is interproximal spaces? It is a triangular shaped area between adjacent teeth in same arch cervical to contact area and absorbed from basal aspect. It means that the interproximal spaces are usually in a triangle shape between the two adjacent teeth in same arch, and which we absorb it from a facial aspect. It is normally filled with gingival tissues, which is part of periodontal ligaments. The triangle is formed at alveolar bone is at its base. The proximal surface is on its sides and the contact area is at apex. Here we can see in a diagram the interproximal spaces. Now moving forward, so its size and shape depend upon the form and location of all the boundaries. Its triangular shape is consequences of its health and have special importance in stimulation of periodontium. It means that triangular shape has have importance, that it have health consequences. It means that if it is proper, and it will stimulate periodontium. Now we have embrasures. Embrasures, actually the open spaces between the proximal surface of two adjacent teeth in same arch, where they diverge in position from contact area. So embrasures are named according to their location from the aspect where the teeth are being viewed. So craniofacial or lingual aspect, two impressions are, one is incisors and the other cervical. When weaving teeth from incisors aspect, the two embrasures are visible, labial and lingual. The functions of embrasures are, it acts as a spillway for the food during mastication, it acts as integral part of self-cleaning process of tooth, and these both processes are interrelated and tend to complement each other, are both protection and stimulation of periodontium. If the embrasures are improper, so they have lack protection, which results in overstimulation of periodontium, which will result in breakdown. In the interior part, it also have aesthetic roles in human dentition. Thanks.